Rachel, why does dark fiber exist?
Dark fiber originated mostly as a result of the crash of the NASDAQ in March 2000. Prior to this crash, there was a period of extreme investment optimism. This period is now commonly referred to as the dot-com bubble. The stock market was skyrocketing, and investors were desperate to maximize their earnings on this potential, many by pouring money into highly speculative internet-based companies, commonly referred to as dot-coms. As a result, investment firms and major corporations received a windfall of added investment capital. Because telecommunication, and more specifically fiber, was considered a great investment in the future, a large portion of these funds was invested in the expansion of optical fiber routes nationwide to enhance telecommunication infrastructures. Unfortunately, after the crash of 2000, these funds dried up. Many of the companies that had the rights to these fiber networks either went bankrupt or had to abandon their goals of utilizing this fiber. This resulted in hundreds of thousands of miles of unlit dark fiber. Dark fiber is optical fiber that is lying dormant in the ground.
If you would like to watch other videos which address related topics, please click on one of these green links. Or click the link directly beneath this video to use our patented real-time pricing tool. This pricing tool is easy to use, and there is no obligation. Our pricing tool will assist you in checking prices and availability for any business telecom service for your business location, including T1, Ethernet, fiber, voice, VoIP, larger circuits like DS3, FastE, or GigE, or networking between business locations for any location in the United States or international networks. Please visit our website at www.fiberlinecommunications.com. I'm Jody Ellen, the Director of Training here at Fiberline Communications. Thank you for joining us today for this training session.